Now, Mules did an awful lot of the farm work in Carroll County. If we go back to when tractors weren't available or just starting to become known. Now, mule, a little bit different kind of an animal. It's a sterile hybrid. Cross between a jack, that's a male donkey, and a mare, a female horse. Because there are different chromosome numbers in donkeys and horses, mules can't reproduce. To get another mule, you don't make two mules. It's got to be a jack and a mare. And of course, all you got to do is talk to some of these mule people and they'll tell you that a mule has all the best features of both horses and donkeys. Now here in Westminster, along with most good country towns, there was a mule dealer. Had a barn on John Street. And every spring, he'd get a box car full of mules from out west. Whether we're talking about Missouri or Tennessee or wherever. Bring that into a train station there in Westminster, herd those mules up Main Street and down John Street and into his barn. And of course, all the farmers knew those mules were coming. So they'd start coming in, and if they needed a mule or a pair of mules on their farm that year, they'd be coming in to see them. And of course, some of these mules were extremely well broken. And probably some of them hadn't seen a whole lot of people. So the well broken ones, I'm sure, cost more. But farmers depended on how well they felt they could work with the mules, depending on what kind of mule they would buy. Mules come in all colors. These two mules are what we would call draft mules, probably by a large jack. And because of the color, I'm going to say they're out of a Percheron mare. These would be good examples of the kind of mules that were worked in Carroll County back in the 1920s and 30s, and later. Our first prize and grand champion mule goes to number 250, Homer! Exhibited by Tom Cashman from Chancellor Farms. Second and reserve grand champion goes to 251 Hector, also a Chancellor Farm mule exhibited by Lexi Caples. Looking for a nice big youth showmanship class next. I want to remind you, I announced earlier, Mr. Cashman, who just showed that grand champion mule, lost his granddaughter to cancer back in April of 2012. She was only 14 years old. She was a patient at St. Jude's Children's Hospital, and he got to see the tremendous hardships those families go through out there, hardships that he went through. So he's partnering with St. Jude's Hospital to do a fundraiser. And he's going to be riding Homer We just saw Homer out here in the ring from here to St. Jude's Hospital. And he really would love to have you sponsor him. Any amount, big or small, would be greatly appreciated. He says, thank you and God bless you. I've got flyers over here which help you find him, but all you got to do is go down there and find him with those two good mules and take care of him.
Everybody's in.
Okay. I just don't know.
We're looking for a great big youth showmanship class. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 entries. So bring them on, please.
She's going to be, she has show number 222 on there.
So what happened? So Novak is up here with Cinco's mail?
Yes, correct.
Okay, I'll probably
And I don't know what number she has on her back. She's using Rosemary's number. Let's see, 222 she has.
Okay.
So that's where she's at.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry about that.
No problem.
Now this class is for young people between the ages of 14 to 19. And Judge Mullen is going to look at how well these young people show these horses. Confirmation of the horse doesn't count. And looking at the ability of that young person to exhibit that horse. And so this is the way a lot of young people get started showing horses. And if we look in here, we've got all four breeds represented. North American Spotted Draft just went up to Judge Mullen. Next in line here would be a Belgian. Percheron, another North American Spotted Draft. Two Percherons, a Belgian. And on the far end is a Clydesdale. So all four breeds are represented here. But again, confirmation of the horse doesn't count in this class. Next class is youth showmanship for younger exhibitors. Then, draft horse under saddle. We start with Western adult to ride. Then Western youth to ride. English adult to ride, English youth to ride, mule under saddle, adult to ride, and then youth to ride, and that finishes up the morning show. Well, it's already past 12 o'clock. Well, we got a number of classes to go, but got a lot of good ones coming after our lunch break. 6-horse hitch class. You don't want to miss that. All of us that have ever shown horses have had what we might call embarrassing moments in the show ring. And while we're never happy about it, you know, you just keep on going. If you look in the ring, here's several of these horses. I've got their manes rolled and their tails tied up. And this is very appropriate for showing horses. And you decorate them in your farm's stable colors. So if you would see two of them out here with the same colors on, they came from the same farm, same stable. If we go back 100 years, companies had their colors, and when they turned their horses, their teams, out on the street, those teamsters had those horses clean, decorated in company colors, harness was shining, and the wagons were all cleaned up. They took great pride in how they presented their teams and vehicles on the street, just the way our exhibitors take great pride in how they present their animals in the show ring.
What you got here for me, dear? There'll be more changes.
Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure, Bob. I'm sure.
Nice, great, big class of young exhibitors. In this class, they're between the ages of 14 and 19. Next class is 8 to 13 year olds.
awake.
Always enjoy seeing a great big class of young exhibitors. This is one of those classes where I don't envy Judge Mullen at all. He's got a whole bunch of real good young people out there in front of him, and he's got to place them.
Thank you. Okay.
Another change.
Another change, yep. We're doing away with this whole class.
Oh, okay.
We're gonna run out of time. We gotta be out of here, you know.
Do we have any time limits?
We gotta be out of here by 5 o'clock. We got all the hitches to go.
We're not gonna finish.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm saying if we finish this, we hit you two, we'll just have to go full bore.
Somebody bring me lunch. We won't have a lunch break.
Well, you figure 10 to 1, we just have the ride
left. Oh, we got a lunch break between the harness and the lunch.
So we can do like we can do a half an hour at 2 o'clock, we'll start the 6 horse hitch.
Matt's gotta be, you know, which is up now, because
he does pretty much have most of them done.
Danny, we're worried about how short to make this lunch break, because we've got to finish by 5 o'clock. That means you're going to have to move like a lightning to get that 6 horse hitch ready.
Now, if you look in the ring, you see what's happening right now. Judge Ryan Mullen is walking up the line, talking to each one of these young exhibitors, telling them what they did well and how they can improve for the next time. And we always appreciate that kind of education for our young exhibitors.
Thank you.
Now, results are headed my direction, but let's reward every one of these good 8 young people in the ring. First prize! Gonna go to entry number 222. That's Rebecca Clippinger, showing solid rock, Rosemary. Second prize, number 238, Kylie Lewis, showing Smith Hills, Last Banjo. Third, number 243, that's Anna Ruby, showing Charlie Brown. And president of the Maryland Directors Mule Association, Neil Parrish, has given them some special awards. Fourth, number 233 is Hope Reed, showing Ace. Fifth prize, number 223, Jared Morrison, showing Diesel. Sixth is number 212, Brandon Novak, showing Smithville Emmy's Cinco de Mayo. Seventh prize goes to number 210, Gage Lewis, showing Bell. Eight, number 239, Lyle Parrish, showing Legacy's Monarch. We need the younger youth showmanship class next. Bring them in. Now we've got this younger youth showmanship class, 2 entries. Then we're going to be looking for under saddle, so let's be getting horses tacked and be ready to roll. Looking for first under saddle class is Western Adult to Ride. And then we'll follow that with English Adult to Ride, English Youth, Mule Western Adult, Mule Western Youth. Then we'll get ready for a 6-horse hitch class.
Yes, she did that last.
Holy smokes, who gets the award for the best hair?
We only got one, Bob.
This is our class. The other entry is a scratch. But all the more reason why those of you in that adult ride Western better be getting ready in a hurry. once again, this youth showmanship class is, as well as the past, sponsored by Maryland Draft Horse and Mule Association, which means they present some special awards to these young people. Another good young show person in the ring, and you can see that Judge Mullen is talking to her and telling her what she did well and how she can improve for her next time in the ring. We're going to go ahead and present first prize to 238 Emma Ruby, showing Smith Hill's last Phantom Joe. And again, the Maryland Draft Horse and Mule Association President Neil Parrish is presenting them with a special award.